Police Squad, in color. Starring Leslie Nielsen. Also starring Alan North. And Rex Hamilton as Abraham Lincoln. Tonight's special guest star, Florence Henderson.
Hold on, I...
Tonight's episode, Terror in the Neighborhood.
Vic tells me that some of the money I gave you to pay the Frenchman was missing.
The place was a front for a dealer named Veronica Rivers.
Unfortunately, our contact in the organization is gone now, Frank. And what's worse is we don't have a line up the supplier. Some guy called the Frenchman.
Until we get him, there's no sense going after the little fish.
That's right. And to get the big fish, we're going to need some bait.
Did you get anyone else on the inside?
Well, there is a job at Mr. V's open right now.
Joey's.
As I see fingers up.
Let me show you what we did. These guns are identical to the one that killed Jim Johnson. Watch carefully as I test fire this gun into these videotapes of Barbara Walters' interviews.
I used to be. I just got laid off today.
Well, since this is your first time here, can I see some identification, Mr. Twice?
Yeah, sure. Here's my driver's license.
Do you have two major credit cards? Thumbprint here, please. Now, stand on that line and look directly into the camera. Thank you. Now, look to your left and cough. And again. Now, spread your toes, please. And the other foot. Thank you.
Oh, hi, Frank. I'm glad you're here. This is a tough one.
What do we got?
One scared lady. Couple of hoods beat up on her real good.
Did she say anything?
No, nothing. Same M.O. as the others.
Right. Where is she?
Right over there. Oh, Frank. It looks pretty bad.
I'm Sergeant Brevin, Jill. I know this may not be the right
Frank,
time.
Frank, not that bad. That's her over there.
Sorry, madam. Jill?
Gentlemen, but the quantity involved was so massive that it is my opinion Mr. Colice's death was either suicide or murder. Now, gentlemen, if you'll excuse me.
Now, Frank, there's another thing about Joey Colice. He was a courier for a major drug-running operation and a police informant. I think he was murdered.
Well, you think he was killed because he was a stoolie?
Maybe. He's always bragging about all the big money he handled.
Why don't you run along now, Katie? And next week I'll show you why women can't play professional football.
Please disperse. Nothing for you to see here. Please go home. Keep moving, please. Keep...
Well, Norberg, looks like we made contact with the organization.
No, I was just thinking, Lieutenant. What if we offered one key free for every three keys duplicated?
They know we're not going to be easy. next move is up to them.
But only as a limited time offer.
Terry, can I talk to you in private?
Of course. Let's go out in the Japanese garden.
So you see, Billy, this experiment will prove the Earth's gravity exerts the same pulling force on any object, no matter what size or weight.
Gee.
Let me show you what I've done. The bowling ball weighs 10 pounds. Your next-door neighbor, Dr. Maurice Shanebaum, weighs 175 pounds.
You think you're going to arrest me, don't you? Well, you're not, because I got the gun now. And I'm going to kill all of you, one by one.
Nice work, Frank.
What?
Lakefront. My God, you know how big that area is? My daughter's a needle in a haystack.
That's not true. I've seen a picture of her. She's very attractive.
Maybe a little thin. Don't you worry. We've got everything under control.
Mr. Burton, we have men working around the clock trying to locate your daughter. Warner Burton's fears were real. Time was running out for Terry. Ed and I drove around for hours for no particular reason. We came up empty.
You better check your sources, Frank. Find out what the word on the street is. Frankly, I think that's our only chance.
Now, let me show you what happens when the gun is fired from 3 feet, which is the distance Sally claimed the shots were fired from. Did you bring me your crying Judy doll?
Here she is, Mr. Olson.
All right. Let's see what happens when we put crying Judy in the trash compactor.
Come and see us anytime, Mr. Price.
Thank you.
Back to the lab to find out what Olson had come up with. The rock that came through our window was their first warning. I knew it wouldn't be long before we were contacted again.
So, Billy, electrostatic particles are created by an imbalance of electrons. The resulting charge is what we scientists call static electricity.
Gee.
It's just like when your mom takes a dress out of the dryer, puts it on, and it clings to every supple curve and soft round... Oh, hi, Frank. Why don't you run along now, Billy? Next week, don't forget to bring in those magazines you found under your father's bed.
He's holding the girl hostage.
I'm going over there, Frank, and try to get behind him. Cover me.
Me very carefully and do exactly as I do. Okay? And
It's payday, teacher. Let's have the 50 bucks.
Look, I don't have anything this week. Business is really bad. Come on, come on. Continue, girls. Come on.
Ain't that too bad? Looks like the teacher needs a few lessons, Rock. Give it a business.
No, please, don't.
It's okay, sweetheart. I'm just going to rearrange that pretty little face of yours.
Key is ready.
It's very interesting. I have a theory about that. As you know, Frank, billions of years ago, our Earth was a molten mass. But for some reason, not understood by scientists, the Earth cooled, forming a crust, a hard, igneous shell, what we scientists call rock.
Could be, but this one has an interesting wrinkle. The gunman twice is a good family man with no prior record.
Can I talk to her?
Sure.